Hello friends, welcome to Educational and Technical Guruji channel. So today I want to discuss about one important sum. I'm really sorry about the condition of the camera, because actually, you know, I was just solving the problem. Let me introduce the problem. Basically, I was solving the class 11th NCERT mathematics textbook, and I was doing the sum number 10 from the miscellaneous exercise on chapter 7. The sum is on permutations and combinations, and the answer that is given, you know, in the NCERT answer set means I have the book, and you know, in the back of the book, the answer that is given is like this: 22 is 7 plus 22 is 10. And I was just analyzing the question, and you know I did the answer, and what NCERT gave, you know, I have also, what I want to say you that what answer, you know, they have given, that answer is actually theoretically right. And you know, there are many such online providers like Learn, CBSC, Vedantu, and many more, like in the website, and same goes for the YouTube channels, okay, who provide the solutions to this NCERT questions, right? And they are doing really a good work. They are doing really a good job. And even in many cases when I fail to understand any problem, yeah, I seek help from them. However, this problem, I saw that, you know, all of them, like Vedantu, Learn, CBSC, all the websites that provide free NCERT solutions, plus the YouTube channels that provide free NCERT solutions, they have approached this question in a similar type of way, and according to me, that similar type of way, by approaching that question in a similar type of way, though gives you a correct answer, that's not theoretically appropriate, right? So let me first tell you what are the solutions, you know, the way Vedantu, Learn, CBSC, and the other websites, and plus the YouTube channels that provide, you know, the solutions to these problems, like Arvind Academy, Learn CBSC, and many more. I don't know, you know, I forgot all those names. They have provided in this way. Actually, I am holding the camera in my hand, so it's, you know, be sympathetic with me, it's a little bit, you know, problematic. And now, though I have my whiteboard, now it's quite inaccessible due to, you know, some odd time. So please watch this in my copy. So the solution as given by the websites and the YouTube is like, you know, they have told that, okay, from a class of 25 students, 10 are to be chosen for an excursion party. So you have a class of 25 students, and out of this 25 students, 10 are going to an excursion party, and 10 students out of that 25 students are to be chosen by the school authority, to take them to an excursion party. And three students who decide that either all of them will join or none of them will join. So there are three students, say A, B, and C are three students out of all those 25 students, who say that either we three will go, fine, and if we three are not selected, like suppose if A is only selected, or like B is only selected, or like C is only selected, or like A, B is selected, C is not selected, like B, C is selected, A is not selected, or A, C is selected, B is not selected. So in such a typical cases, they will not go. They will go only if they are together, means triply there, ABC triply, they will go, and if they are not together, they will not go. So it is what means by this, that there are three students who decide that either all of them will join or none of them will join. So the meaning is like this: and in how many ways can the excursion party be chosen? Fine. So what the Vedantu, I mean not particular, in general, because every websites and every YouTube channel who provide these NCERT solutions, they have approached the problem in the same manner like what I am going to tell you right now. So they have told that, okay, fine, you know, we have two cases. First case, like three students will join or will go. Okay, they have told that fine, three students will go is one of the cases, and second case is they don't go. So if they go, then according to those websites and the YouTube channel, if those three students go, you know, actually 25, so they go means they are selected. They are telling that three students will go means they are selected. So suppose three students are selected according to them, and so 25 minus 3 means 22 are left to be selected, and we need to select 22. We need to select 3 are already selected from and 10 are to be selected, so 10 minus 3 means 7 are left to be selected from 22. So we need to select 7 from 22. This is like this combination, 22 distant objects taken 7 at a time. This is quite clear. So they are telling that if three students go, if the case is like, you know, three students will go means they are will join, three students will join, it means that they are selected, and 25 minus 3 is 22, like this they can go. And you know, they don't go, if they don't go, this is quite simple, that well, they have done that, they don't go, so you know 25 students minus 3 equals to 22. After 22 students, I have to select 7 students because 3 students are not going to go. And therefore, the number of ways this excursion party can be chosen is that if they go, it is 22, you know, sorry, I have to choose 10 here, C7 plus 22 C2. And this, in this pattern, NCERT gave me the answer. But this is my method, what I thought, and I think that this is the most appropriate method. You see for yourself, like I told that fine, three students will decide that either all of them will join or none of them will join. Okay, fine. So when three students are deciding that they will join, means the three will join, it never implies that you know selection is dependent on the school authority. It depends on how the school authority, or you know, that the or the college authority, you approach this problem. For the school, that's quite simple. Selection is done by the school authority. So what I think is that, like, if school authority does the selection, then first of all, they will take 25 students, they will select 10 students out of 25 students, fine. And you know, you will have 25 C10, you know, this list of combinations, and you may say that this is equals to, I am finding it using my scientific algorithm, 25 C10 3268760. So there are 3268720 such, you know, combinations, and the main thing is that if you know if any one of the combination, like suppose A B C D E F G H I J 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 18 19 20 21 22 23 24 25. So these are the 25 students, the name suppose, and suppose I say that this A, B and C, these are those three fellows who decide that the either they will go, you know, either they together will join or they will not join. It means if the selection is such that A, B and C falls in any, or you know, this is the list of combinations, and in this combinations things may occur like, you know, A, B, C, 3 has occurred triply. By triply I means they have occurred jointly, you know, together. So A, B, C and any 7 of this, so this may be one of the combination, or combinations may be like that, like only A is there, or only B is there, or only C is there, A, B is there, like B, C is there, or A, C is there. So in these cases of combinations concerning A, B and C, these three these three students, we may say from here that three students who decide that either all of them will go or none of them will join, whether all of them will go and none of them will join. So it means that in all those cases A, B and C, they don't occur triply, they don't occur together, and in these six such consequences, A, B and C will not go, because it is already told that either all of them will go or they will not go. So in these six such consequences, A, B and C will not go. A, B, C will not go only when A, B and C will occur together. This is quite simple. So now what I am doing is that suppose how many combinations can be like this, quite simple. So I need to form 10 students, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So like this I need to find 10 students. I make A fixed and I have 9 boxes left to be filled up. So can't I say that, you know, like A is there, right? B, C, if these two are there, then A, B and C they will go. So that's not the problem. I want to ask you how many combinations are there in which there are only A, there are not B, there are not C, there are only A, there are not B, there are not C. So B is not there, C is not there, and you know, so there are actually there are 25 students, and A you have already taken fixed, so you have to make selection of 1, means 24 students. But I have also told you that B and C are not there, so from you need to subtract 2, means from what you need to select, so from that you need to subtract 2, means 22, because B and C is not there. Are you understanding me? Yes or no? Very good. So 22, so you are gonna select 9, 1, 2, 3 versus 29, you are gonna select 9 guys from 22, fine. Same goes for B, because you are fixing here B, you don't take A, you don't take C. So B, C and A, you subtract 3 directly from 25, you got 22, and you have for B you have 22, C 9. So only B, no A, no C, only A, no B, no C, like this possibilities are 22, C 9. Same goes for C, 22, C 9, no A, no B. So like this. Now let us find for AB. Finding AB is also very easy. So here, you know, you have 10 boxes like that. You fix A and B. And you know that if C occurs, then A, B, C occurs, and A, B and C will occur. So that's not the case. I want to ask you how many combinations are there where you have A and B, but you don't have C, you have no C. So you have 8 boxes available right here. How many boxes? 8 boxes available right here. And the material, you know, the number of students from which the selection will occur, since I told you that there is no C, AB is fixed, so I can subtract 25 minus 3. Can I? Very good. So 22 is there. So I need to select 8 boxes are there, 8 from 22, 8 for 22. So same for this, you fix BC and you say that there is no A. So this number of combinations will be 22, C8, and for this will be 22, C8. Okay, fine. So we have seen that, you know, you have 22 C9, and here 22 C9, you know, combinations where you have A only, where you have B only, where you have C only, where you have AB only, you have 22 C8 combinations, where you have BC only, you have 22 C8. BC only means, you know, these things can occur in random. I mean, BC only means there is no A. That's the condition which I have followed while doing it. I have already described to you before. And while for AC, I have this much of combinations. Now, they have asked me, think carefully, that they have asked me in how many ways excursion party can be chosen. So when the school authority does the complete combination, it's 25 C10. So, you know, if I write that the number of ways in which the excursion party can be completed is 25 C10, you see that here A, B, C, in all such combinations, all the six combinations, since A, B, C, A, B, B, C, A, C occurs, so they will not occur. You know what I mean, that suppose in all these 22 C9 combinations, there is A only, there is no B, there is no C, so A is not going to go in the excursion. The rest nine are going to go in the excursion. So, but this combination will not be valid. Same goes for this combination, same goes for this, and same goes for all these six combinations. So all these six combinations are not going to be valid. So we need to find the exact number of valid combinations, and the exact number of valid combinations will be 25 C10, that is the total number of combinations, minus the sum of all this, because these are invalid. Why invalid? I have already told you. Say this, in this combination you have A only, you have no B, you have no C, and these are in random. D, E, F, Y is in random. So if there is A only, and if there is no B and no C, this is not, this condition is not valid, because if there is no B and no C, according to the question, A is not going to go, and if A is not going to go, the other three, you know, nine are going to go, but A is not going to go. So in this combination is not valid in that sense, and all these combinations are not valid. So you see 22 C9 three times, so 322 C9 plus 322 C8, I subtract from the original combination number to the number of invalid combinations, and by doing so, let me see what is the number of valid combinations. 25 C10 minus, I take 3 common, 22 C9 plus 22 C8. I am doing all this, you know, to save time in the scientific calculator. C8, and I get 817190. These are the number of valid combination. It means in these combinations you have either A, B, C present in some of this. You know, 817190 means 1,100,000 is 1,000,000. 817,190 combinations, and you list, and you know, in the set consisting of 817,190 combinations, you will find some in which you will have A, B, C together, or in which you will have, you know, leaving A, B, C, you will have the combinations of from D to Y. Are you getting my point? From D to Y, you will have A, B, C together with some, or ABC you leave it, and D to Y. So this is the type of combinations that are available within this number, and these combinations are valid. However, these are not valid. So from the original, I have subtracted the invalid to get the valid, and this is what the question asks. Now, what NCERT has provided in his answer, in its answer set, is something like this, and I think that's on the basis of this, you know, the websites and the YouTube channels and all, they have proposed their answer like like this, but I think this method to be much much more appropriate than this method. What do you think? Please leave your comments, your views in the comment section below. And if you want me to compare my answer with NCERT's answer, you see 22.7 in my scientific calculator, 22.7 plus 22.10 will give you the same result, 817190. However, this method is much more appropriate, and I want you all to accomplish this method while solving this type of problem. So you think whether this which method is better, and I think that this is the best, this is correct, not like this. Thank you for seeing my channel.